In mid-January of 2024, CNN published an article about the dramatic increase in wealth of the five richest people in the world, and billionaires in general. The title of the article stated that the wealth of the five richest people has more than doubled since 2020. I read the article and did a little research. I wanted to find out how much better these top five are doing as investors compared to what a typical person could do with their own money. It turns out, the most basic investment strategy would have put you right there with the top five, and better than most billionaires in general. The top five wealthiest individuals in the world are Jeff Bezos, Warren Buffett, Bernard Arnault, Larry Ellison, and Elon Musk. The CNN article calculated the increase in wealth of these five individuals from March of 2020, where the stock market hit a low due to the pandemic, until the end of 2023 or early 2024. Here are the increases of each of their fortunes in percentages. Those are solid numbers. In the case of Elon Musk, that is phenomenal. On average, across those five, they saw an increase of just over 100%, or double their net worth from 2020. For all billionaires as a group, their net worth increased an average of 34% from March of 2020. How much better is this than what a typical investor could do? Say, invest in an S&P 500 mutual fund, or ETF. Here's a chart of the S&P 500 from March of 2020 until mid-February of 2024. At the dip in March of 2020, the S&P 500 was at 2304. By January 12th, 2 days before the article came out, the S&P 500 was 4783. That's an increase of 107.6%. But that was just the growth in the value of price, and doesn't include reinvested dividends. Dividends are company profits that a company shares with stockholders. Someone that invested in the S&P 500 would see an increased growth of about 12% due to dividends, and growth on reinstated dividends in that period. That means a typical investor could have earned about 119.6%. The article did adjust for inflation, and we will do the same. An online inflation calculator estimated that the rate of inflation from March of 2020 to January of 2024 to be 19%. So it would take $119 in January 2024 to buy the same amount of goods as $100 in March of 2020. That means our growth of 119% when we adjust for inflation could be darn near 100%. Or in other words, money invested in the stock market in the dip in March of 2020 would have doubled by January of 2024 in real terms. How does that compare to the growth of the five richest people in the world? It beats the pants off of two of them. It almost matches two of them and is left in the dust still by Musk. So doubling your money during that time period is not that big of a deal. Anyone could have done that by investing in a fund that follows the S&P 500 index. There are two really interesting insights we learned from this quick analysis. First, I think it's extremely surprising that billionaires as a whole are doing so poorly compared to following the stock market. Warren Buffett's wealth didn't even come close to matching the growth of his own company. Only Elon Musk greatly surpassed the growth of the S&P 500. But that's because his wealth, like many others, is tied to the growth of his own companies. Tesla went up 634% in that same period, and SpaceX went up 300%. But Tesla is a public company, so anyone with money to invest could have invested in Tesla and almost matched Musk's amazing growth. Of course, the problem is knowing back in March of 2020 which companies, like Tesla, would have such high growth, and which ones would struggle, or even tank. That's why many investors play it safe by investing in a broad swath of companies by picking an index. So why didn't the CNN article mention this? This brings me to the second interesting insight from this analysis, the importance of quantitative literacy. Quantitative literacy is the math, stat, and probability skills needed to smoothly handle everyday quantitative situations. From reading news articles, to judging claims on social media, understanding the effects of compounding interest and inflation, etc. It grabs readers' attentions to highlight the crazy amount of money the richest people have. That's for sure. But a quantitatively literate person will find that the article had to reach to try and make billionaires' net worth increase of 34% seem astonishing instead of dismal. They claimed that the wealth of billionaires was growing three times as fast as the rate of inflation, which sounds a lot more dramatic than, billionaires really suck at investing and are only getting a return of about one-third the rate of the US stock market. I looked at my 401k balance, and it had basically doubled in the same period. Maybe I should market my investing genius to some of those billionaires who are struggling to match my wealth growth. Another aspect of this situation that a quantitatively literate person might question is the choice of the top five. The top five now are not necessarily the top five last year or in 2020 when they started this comparison. The headline becomes even more dismal if we look at how the top five from March of 2020 are doing now. Elon Musk wasn't even close to the top five back then, and instead, we had Bill Gates in the top five. Bill's growth went from $98 billion to about $123.8 billion now. But most of that was due to inflation. Discounting for inflation, that's only the equivalent of $103.61 billion, a measly growth of 5.7%. Replacing Elon's growth with Bill's gives us an average increase of only 51%, far from the 114% given in the article. By picking the top 5 billionaires today, they're picking those who are already doing well, so naturally the growth will seem phenomenal. If they didn't get decent growth, they wouldn't have ended up in the top 5. Like many media outlets, the article goes for the dramatic headline. That's reasonable, since they're trying to increase readership. Hey, we do the same thing to get viewers to watch our videos. The point is that it's important to remember to be a savvy consumer of media. Be a little skeptical. Part of being quantitatively literate is the ability to question and analyze quantitative claims like the ones in this article. Remember that media outlets, advertisers, government entities, and businesses don't always have your best interests at heart. Do you see other things a quantitatively literate person might consider as they read this article? Go ahead and put them in the comments. There are many more that we haven't mentioned in this video. And as a final disclaimer, remember, we are not investing experts. Nothing in this video is meant to tell you if or how you should invest your money. But we do hope that this video helps highlight the importance of quantitative literacy, so you too can be a little skeptical and make well-informed decisions for yourself. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and share our videos. Be sure to follow Math the World on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Thank you so much for your support.